Microchip has made delays really, really easy for us. It used to be really hard to get a precise delay written in C. But the XC8 compiler has these delays tied up neatly in these three functions. And they are delay in milliseconds, delay in microseconds, and delay for a number of clock instructions. And these functions are really easy to use. You just type out the name of the function, and then for the arguments, you put in the number. Say we're using delay in milliseconds. We put in 500 milliseconds. So that will wait for half a second. Or if we need something smaller, like we're driving a LED display or something, sometimes we need microseconds. So we'll say we'll delay for 30 microseconds. Delay for clock instructions is pretty interesting. Say you have a 20 megahertz crystal, and that is your main clock for your microprocessor. If you want to put in, say, 1,000 instructions for a delay, well, that would give you a delay of about 50 microseconds. But say you switch that crystal out for a 4 megahertz crystal. Now your delay is going to be about 250 microseconds because your clock has slowed down. Now this can be really helpful not only to scale it if your frequency changes on your microprocessor, but also some projects will not have a crystal or a clock that runs at a certain frequency. Sometimes the clock will come into the project as inputs, and that's getting kind of complicated, but do know that you can delay for a certain amount of instruction cycles. Now, one more thing about these delay functions. If you go back and watch the first video, we talked about setting up our clock frequency. And if we do not do this, it will none of these little delay functions will work. So you need to make sure that you have your proper frequency. I have 4 megahertz here, and this needs to be in your defines, which is right under your includes and your pragmas. It goes right here. If you don't do that, you will not have a delay function that works, and it may or may not throw a syntax error. So you need to be really careful about that and make sure that gets in there. Well, that's it for delays, but stay tuned. In the next episode, we're going to start lighting up some LEDs and learning how to turn the pins on and off. And don't forget to like and subscribe and ask questions if you have any. And I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. and you can see our program is working. Now, the way this works is the while command begins, and it sees that its argument is true. So it begins to execute the code inside its curly brackets. So it calls the blink command, and then delays for 250 microseconds, and then returns back to the beginning of the while command. And since its argument is true and always will be true, it will repeat forever.